Hello, I'm Paul Peterson. Hey, is it time to throw out that mini skirt and donate those jeans to Goodwill? Some fashion experts think that there is no reason to look old when it comes to dressing. Please stay tuned for Aging in LA. The rules of fashion are constantly changing and becoming increasingly difficult as we age. Or are they? Today's guest pioneered the concept of the designer resale store 35 years ago when she opened her first resale boutique in Los Angeles. After the overwhelming success of her first venture, she opened a boutique on Wilshire Boulevard in Santa Monica in 1986. And we will visit there later in the program and watch a senior citizen undergo a fashion makeover. She came of age during the fabulous 40s, the golden age of Hollywood glamour, when every woman aspired to look and dress like a movie star. Please welcome our guest, a specialist in contemporary couture clothing, Maureen Klavan, proprietress of the Address Boutique. Maureen, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
I love this term, proprietress.
Yes.
That's lovely. But we can say boss, too. Huh?
Okay, yes, definitely.
How did you get such a notion that there would be both a market and a pool of people interested in the recycling, if you will, of designer clothing?
I guess I was ahead of the times, actually.
I'll say you were green before it was cool.
Yes, and when I first started, which was in 1963, when I had my first store, I had access, we belonged to a club, and I had access to a lot of women who could only even then wear their clothes maybe once. Mm. And so I just thought, gee, what a great idea to recycle things. And so that's when I opened my first little store. Mm-hmm. And then this store, which I've had since 1968, mm-hmm. and actually, it's been terrific. I had a second career. When I was 58, I started this store, mm-hmm. and that was 22 years ago. So
I'm not doing the math.
No, please don't. Please don't.
Nonetheless, but how do you talk, really, some elegant women, mm-hmm. accomplished women, into parting with some of their favorite things?
Well, first of all, it's very timely to do that now. Mm-hmm. They like to recycle the things. Second yes. of all, these women can really only be seen in something once, if that. Mm-hmm. And third of all, they really like getting checks every month. I mean, it doesn't matter what your circumstances are. They love the fact that they can count on a nice check. And they're doing good, you know. They're enabling people to wear wonderful clothes.
Well, now I don't want to push people away here thinking we're talking $10,000 ball gowns. The truth is, there can be some significant savings in your store.
Absolutely, we have things from $2 to I guess you'd say maybe $2,000, but mm-hmm. the $2,000s are very rare. You know, nowadays I just looked in a magazine actually, and the latest Chanel suit that I saw was about $10,000.
Wow.
Well, somebody could buy a Chanel jacket in my store for maybe $300 and a skirt for maybe $50. That's $350, and nobody ever knows that they bought it resale, mm-hmm. and even if they know it, it's the smartest way to shop.
Well, it is, and we all need to be smart shoppers in these days. Now, our audience, of course, is more mature.
Yes.
And I think many, many of our women, older women, somehow think that maybe this is too girlish. Maybe why am I doing this? But making a good appearance is important for a person of any age.
Of any age, absolutely. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I have wonderful women that work for me, mm-hmm. and so they make regulars of these customers, right. and they get personalized help. And really, you're as old as you feel or as young as you feel. Mm-hmm. And there's some women who come in at 40 who say, oh, I can't wear jeans, I'm too old. And there are other women who come in at 70 and say, I love those jeans, I want to get those. So it's yeah. all in your head, actually.
Yeah, you know? I think you're absolutely right there. And And what a shame, though, that we limit ourselves. Maybe it takes a person like you or a sympathetic staff to say, hey, why don't you try this?
Try it. It's fun. Mm-hmm. And, you know, nowadays it's really the smart way to shop. And we have customers. When I first started, it was kind of a whisper thing. It was like nobody wanted to wear somebody else's clothes.
Sure.
Now it's a smart way to shop. Mm-hmm. And I have customers that the minute they come in town, they call me from the airport. How do I get to your store? I saw it on a show such as this. Mm-hmm. I want to come in and buy some clothes.
Well, and I think that's, first of all, I happen to like shopping, but you know, I'm sort of a Mr. Mom to boot, but the experience
is wonderful.
Well, it can be because you're kind of, I mean this in the nicest
yes.
sense, old school, to take care of the customer and befriend them and become sensitive to what they want to be.
And the nice thing about shopping in a store like mine, really, and they're all over the world now, there are many stores,
yes.
none quite like mine, however, but it's pretty much one of a kind. In other words, usually when you go into a regular store, quote unquote, there's racks and racks of the same
yeah,
thing.
The cookie cutter. Well, tell you what, why don't we get a chance to
okay.
see your store?
Sure, I'd
and,
love
and
that.
Maureen, if you would describe some of the fashions that are available at the Address Boutique.
Okay.
Okay, the monitor's right over
okey
here.
Okie dokie, let's do well, that.
Now, this is at 11th and Wilshire,
1116 Wilshire Boulevard in Santa Monica. Please don't go downtown, as some people do.
Look how stylish that is. Those are great chrome racks.
We have great chrome racks. We have fabulous gowns. We have everything from jeans to very dressy ball gowns so that you could go to an Academy Award dinner or go to a picnic in your jeans. By the way, jeans now are really important, unlike the way they were when we were growing up. In
mm-hmm.
fact, I was even, well, I shouldn't say we. I couldn't even remember if the kids wore jeans. I don't think we did then.
Mm-hmm.
But now, jeans are very expensive. I mean, it's nothing to spend $500 for a pair of jeans.
Right.
With holes in them,
yeah,
by the way.
Yeah, with holes, no less.
The more holes, the more expensive, actually.
Yeah. Oh, look at those shoes.
Yeah, those are fabulous. And those have antique buckles on them. We have lots of wonderful shoes. Jimmy Choo's, Manolas, Chanel, Prada, Gucci, in every size. Shoes for walking, shoes for dancing. And we have jewelry, we have handbags. As I say, we can take care of you for any occasion.
Yeah.
And we do take care of you for every occasion. Beautiful jewelry. And my sales staff is exemplary. Chrissy's been with me for 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
She's from Brazil. Atsuka has been with me about 8 years. She's from Japan. Madeline's been with me. My manager's been with me for 22 years. And that's Chrissy right there
mm-hmm.
helping a customer. And it's a fun way to shop. It really is.
I'm amazed about this selection. Maureen, there's lots of things in the store.
There's lots of things in the store. Mm-hmm.
Now, did I notice that those price tags are handwritten? Do
yes,
you?
They. Isn't that awful? I haven't
no.
computerized my store
oh,
yet.
I don't mean it that way, but it
no,
means you have evaluated each
yes,
item
I,
that comes in.
Absolutely.
Wow.
And yes, everything is evaluated that
right.
way.
Now, you got to share with me.
Yes.
Do you send some stuff back that someone, a lady of a certain station maybe is trying to foist
you know,
off on you?
You have to kind of use a little bit of diplomacy because
mm-hmm.
some people could care less and other people take it very personal
yeah.
when sometimes there's something I can't use because it has a little stain on it or a little spot on it. And, you know, I have to, well, why aren't you taking this? What's wrong with it? Well, it's got a little something I don't think will come
yeah.
out. In fact, one very famous celebrity, I don't know, can we mention names on this?
Well,
better
carefully.
Not.
It depends on whether or not I like them.
Oh, okay. Four.
Oh, yes. No, that one we'll leave aside.
We'll leave that aside.
She's tougher than
but
I am.
But anyway, no, I went to her house and I said, but you know, I really can't use this. It's got a spot on it. And she said, darling, just tell them it's mine.
So,
but I'm not mentioning any names.
No names at all. No names at all. Well, what about a person? We might have someone out in our audience there who has had in the past a
mm-hmm.
pretty expansive wardrobe, but there are nice gowns or jackets or suits that are kind of at the end of the closet and not being used anymore.
Right.
Can they call you and say, I have some things for you to see?
Absolutely. I'm very accessible. I kind of try to weed them out on the telephone
Certainly.
So as not to waste anyone's time.
Yeah.
But I do go to people's homes by appointment, and I'm pretty fussy, but, you know, I have regular people that I get things from all the time. Some people are really good about it. They go through their closets every 2 months. Other people do it twice a year, something like that. But anyway, we do have fabulous clothes for everybody.
Well, and this is the high end of the resale business. These are designer togs
are, but you get really, really good buys, and it spoils you. Once you start wearing these kind of clothes, you never want to shop any other way.
Right.
And as I say, we cater to people. We have school teachers, we have celebrities, we have businesswomen that come in and shop at the store. And it's cute because even though people tell everyone now, well, sometimes people say, well, you know, my best friend asked me where I got these things, but I couldn't tell her because she's the same size as I am, and I want to have first pick. So, and I say, well, how do you expect me to stay in business if you don't tell people?
Well, right, exactly. Well, I mean, a person, given the selection that we saw, a person can really come in and put more than just one outfit together. It's not like you're just a single target.
No, absolutely. You could come in with a skirt and get a sweater, get a blouse, get a jacket, get shoes, get several different tops. In fact, we even encourage people, you know, maybe you have like a stray skirt at home and you never could find anything to wear with
it.
Bring in the skirt and we'll put something with it. It's a fun way to shop.
That's a great idea.
It is. It's a terrific way to shop.
Yeah, and what about those people who want to, maybe they've come to that point where they say, I need to change my look. I've gotten sort of staid and maybe I'm inside, I don't feel good anymore.
Yes, we're very good at that.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's like a before and after. You can come in and look one way, maybe frumpy, if I can say that word.
Sure. Dowdy, frumpy.
Yeah, and go out looking like a movie star and feeling really good for very little money. I mean, it's a wonderful, wonderful way to shop.
And this extends now through accessories as well. I was amazed.
Just
handbags and
handbags,
shoes. How do you get a person with a shoe, Jones, to give up their shoes?
You know, some people have so many shoes that they just, and sometimes they buy them because they look good and then they realize they can't wear them because they really bought them too small and they can't quite squeeze their foot into it. So that's good for us and bad for them. But anyway, shoes are one thing women have in common. They love shoes, I think, more than anything. They can never have too many shoes. Because usually if you gain weight or lose weight, your wardrobe changes, but your feet pretty much stay the same.
Let's hope.
Let's hope, yes.
Well, as a person who has gone up and down in weight, I know there were times, well, in fact, when I've lost so much weight in the recent past that some of my favorite stuff I had to give up because I was swimming in them.
I know.
Now, a lot of people have undergone dramatic body changes.
Yes, and if they call me, that's terrific because I'd be happy to come out and take a look at their clothes. Also, a lot of women, you know, it's nothing to fluctuate a couple of sizes.
Sure.
And men, too, I'm sure, so that they might have things in their wardrobe that are size 6, 8, and 10, which is interesting in itself, you know. I try to carry a range of sizes. I go from 0 through, like, about size 18. And, however, I have to admit that, you know, a great deal of my clothes are in the smaller sizes because people are so weight conscious in this city. So.
Boy, are they ever. We have definitely got a fitness culture.
It's too bad because you see these girls on the runway and you wonder how they can even walk. I mean, their legs are just spindly, and it's not a good thing.
Well, Thomas Wolfe called them X-ray women.
I see. Yes. Okay.
It's like the confirmation on a very thin racehorse. But the economics of this intrigue me because it's easy to just throw money away, but to shop responsibly, and to find a use for something that otherwise would go unused and maybe even tossed out, that's a smart thing to do in this green world of
ours. Yes, it is a very smart thing to do, and many smart women shop that way.
Mm-hmm.
They really do. And I sell many clothes. We just sold several things for the Emmys. The Oscars will be coming up soon. Right. There's so many award shows in LA, and we have fabulous gowns. I mean, absolutely incredible.
Oh,
and,
I bet you
And
do.
You don't have to spend $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 mm-hmm. now to look gorgeous. You know, you really don't. And at any age, you can look glamorous, really.
Well, that appeals to me. I also like the notion of holding to standards, to the quality of the garments.
Yes.
There is a difference.
The way they're made, once you wear something that has been made by Armani or Gucci or Prada, I mean, you're paying for the name, but you're also paying for the way they're structured.
Right, exactly.
And they feel good. And I have people who come in and say, Maureen, you won't believe this. Remember the suit I got from you 20 years ago? Well, of course I don't remember, but...
Maureen, I got to ask you to hold
yes,
the story.
Of course.
Okay, we have to take a short break.
Okay.
When we return, we'll continue our discussion okay. of the ageless art of fashion with our special guest, Maureen Clavin.
You know, I am getting better. I can still take care of myself. You just don't know.
No. 3 times a day, these drops.
Now that Mom's moved in, life has become a bit more complicated for all of us. We knew there would be challenges, but overall, we're glad to be together.
I don't like to call him in the office when I have to go to the doctor's or if I want to go out.
We're so thankful for the help we received.
You voted for it, we built it. The Department of Public Works Bureau of Engineering promised to improve, renovate, expand, or construct 32 libraries. On time and under budget, we delivered 36.
Welcome back to Aging in LA. Our topic today is the ageless art of fashion. And our special guest is Maureen Clavin, an expert in couture clothing and owner of the Address Boutique in Santa Monica. Maureen, you were telling me about people who've come back to you since you've been in business for
yeah.
a while now, 20 years later, and say, do you remember that wonderful Armani suit I had?
That's right. And actually, that happened just the other day.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, remember what I bought 20 years ago? And she said, actually, I wore it the other night. And she said, I got so many compliments.
Wow.
And so well, besides which, 20 years now would make it pretty much vintage. And
mm-hmm.
vintage is so in right now.
Yes.
Anything that, you know, is from 20 years ago or longer, people clamor for. And especially... You know, unfortunately, some of the designers are no longer with us, so that makes their things even more precious.
Yes,
you know?
I agree. Well, I know I was looking, just shortly, a while ago, I was looking at some of the pictures of, like, Jacqueline Kennedy.
Yes.
She would be stylish in any age.
Absolutely. Well, that look is definitely in the sleeveless little dress
mm-hmm.
and the little simple jacket.
Yes.
And, they, you know, every once in a while they recapture that look.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a lot of those little dresses. And the nice thing about those dresses, they're good for someone any age and you can wear them any place.
Okay. Now, when you say any age, sometimes people of a certain age think, well, I've got to stay with the muted tones. I got to stay in the grays and the browns. But that's just not true anymore.
I don't think you can really have that kind of color.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, my favorite color is actually black. Mm-hmm. And black is always good. And the little black dress is never out of style.
Right.
And Jackie Kennedy with her little black sleeveless and her little pillbox hat
mm-hmm.
was a perfect fashion plate, you
right.
know.
And there's so much you can do with it, too. It's not
yes.
to be forgotten that
no.
sometimes you have the basic garment, and then you can change its appearance entirely. With
earrings or a pashmina or a little bolero jacket
mm-hmm.
or many, many different things.
Now, you know, we're talking about this. So here's, as a treat,
yes.
it's time to watch Maureen in action
oh.
as she advises a senior on how to perk up her wardrobe. So let's watch as Cinda Martin drops in for some wardrobe tips. Here comes Cinda.
And welcome. What can I help you with today?
I want something elegant.
Something elegant.
Yes.
come on back and I'll help you. Cinda, you look so elegant.
Thank you.
I hope you love your outfit.
I love it.
We put you in a St. John for evening knit jacket with a Stuart Weitzman, the lovely little bag. You have your Faith Porter earrings and jewelry, which are so special. We put this with a black jersey skirt and camisole. Now, you can do many changes with this outfit. This particular outfit that you have on is perfect for a graduation, going to a cocktail party, going to a Hollywood premiere, going to a wedding, going to a bar mitzvah. What else can we think of? A fashion luncheon? You would steal the show. So you look absolutely stunning.
Thank you, thank you.
And you know what? With this basic black that you have, I can show you something that actually, I think you said you were going to be going to work. And I can show you something that you can put with this that will take you to an office job, a career job, anything important like that, okay?
Yes.
So let's go back and try it.
Okay.
Okay, good. Okay, Cinda, now what we have here, we have the same skirt and top, and we've put you in this darling little Alberto Macaulay sweater top, which isn't quite as elegant, but is still lovely. Mm-hmm. So now you're dressed for, could be a corporate job. You could be the head person at a bank. You could be the principal of a school. You could be having your own store, whatever that might be. It's lovely for daytime, for morning meetings. And then we also put a purse, a different purse with this. This is a Ferragamo little bag, which is very lovely. And so we could go on and on and on changing tops to put with this black two-piece outfit. And they all work, and you're a lovely model. Turn around for 1 second and let's show the back of this too. So you look just as good in the back as you do in the front, because people do see you both ways.
Okay.
That's terrific. I think we have one more fun outfit.
Okay.
We'll try it. Okay?
Thank you.
Good. So, Cinda, now we have you in an entirely different kind of outfit. A little green cashmere top with pretty little colorful bangles on it. White linen pants and a white linen shell. You could even get married on the beach in Hawaii in this or go to a wedding or just have fun. Go out with your boyfriend at night, go to a club. You have a Lambertson Truex little straw bag there. And again, with this white pants and the white shell, you can do many different tops. But this is colorful and charming and fun.
Yes.
And so you look elegantly fun. Cinda, I think we've fulfilled all of your expectations. We put you in an elegant evening jacket. We got you to work in a wonderful little sweater top. And now you can even go to a wedding in this beautiful little outfit, wear it on the beach, whatever. So I think we had fun with this makeover, and I hope you had a great time.
Oh, I did. Thank you.
What a fun piece, Maureen. That was great. And you say, Cinda, I won't say her age specifically, but octogenarian.
And she is young. There's a perfect example of someone who's young at heart, who doesn't give a hoot about her age, but wants to have fun.
Right. And look good.
And look terrific. Absolutely.
I remember asking my grandfather one time why we had to dress up to go to church. And he says, well, when people dress up, they're better behaved.
That's very good.
You know, if you put a little thought and effort into your wardrobe, it actually can alter your outlook and your behavior.
And the way you stand and the way you think about yourself.
Right. And, of course, posture is so important to people of a certain age because they've gotten maybe a little lazy and they start to slump.
That's for sure.
Why?
Stand up straight.
Proud.
Stand up straight while you can.
Sure. Exactly. I have to ask you, how do the designers feel about this resale market? Are they proud that their fashions have held up over time?
I think they're very proud, actually.
Really?
Yes, absolutely. You know, and many times I get samples from the designers. I mean, I do carry some new things as well. And I try to fill in with the sizes, you know, that are so 12s, 14s, 16s,
right.
and things like that.
Larger size. Well,
right.
we all get a little bigger.
Yes, we do.
Well, before I forget, I want to remind people again, now you're on Wilshire Boulevard in Santa Monica, about 11th.
1116 mm-hmm. Wilshire Boulevard. Right. It's a white building with a bright turquoise fence.
Yeah, I love the outside.
Thank
it was
you.
Very stylish.
And there's parking in the back, mm-hmm. meter parking in the front.
Great.
And we'll greet you with open arms.
Oh, that's fun. Now, again, I want to encourage people to sort of think outside the box here, either to bring you clothes that
yes.
they may wish to share with someone else, but also to
come in and shop. It's a fun way to shop.
Sure,
and they'll
yes.
love our store, and everyone's very friendly.
Yeah.
I have people who've been shopping with me for years, and now they bring their grandchildren in.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to sneak this out here. You had
yeah.
a little list of names of some of the people that you might bump into.
Well, these are some of the people who are actually in their 60s that you never think of it that way.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
and
I mean,
are
like,
still quite fashionable.
Very. I mean, Barbara Streisand, mm-hmm. Jane Fonda, Priscilla Presley, Diane Sawyer.
Yeah.
I mean, these are all glamorous, wonderful women who could easily be 30 or 40.
Right, and nobody is saying that they're too severe.
No.
Or they're dressing inappropriately, because the fact is they wear their outfits proudly
exactly.
and they look good.
And they look fabulous.
Sure.
And incidentally, on the walls of my store
mm-hmm.
are pictures of many celebrities that I get clothes from, and you'll find some very, very famous names there.
Well, there's something special about that.
You
know,
yes,
you can say,
you're
well,
the same size as somebody, you know.
Right, of course.
Whose name they'll have to come in and see.
Oh, Maureen, this has been such a treat, and I'm pleased to let Los Angeles know that the Address Boutique is here and that you're here to help them with their fashion
thank
concerns.
You so much for choosing our store. It's been wonderful and so lovely, and we'll look forward to seeing all your friends.
Great, thank you. It's time is up for today's edition of Aging in LA. Thanks so much to our guest Maureen Klavan from the Address Boutique on Wilshire Boulevard in Santa Monica. And now it's time for our feature on Aging in LA, Senior Stat Shots, where we look at statistics or information that pertains to senior citizens. And once again, we found today's statistics in the recently released LA County Seniors Count, a survey of the older adult population in Los Angeles City and County. We featured this survey before on our program. Now, in our last program, we looked at statistics that showed various degrees of difficulty that some seniors have in performing everyday tasks, such as getting in and out of bed, preparing and eating meals, and using the telephone. Today, we will look at statistics that show who helped them with their tasks. Of those who had some degree of difficulty with these tasks, 17% were assisted by their spouse, 12% by another relative, 4% had a friend help them, 6% were helped by a volunteer or agency, and 28% had no one to help them. 32% of those asked this question did not respond. And that's today's Senior Stat Shot. Now, you can get your own copy of this fact-filled survey. Simply go online to the Los Angeles County Community and Senior Services. The website is up there on your screen. Just click on LA County Seniors Count, and the full report will appear. I'm Paul Peterson for the Los Angeles Department of Aging, the people here at City View Channel 35, and all of our guests on Aging in LA. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.